This case is going to be very emotional, so at any point you find yourself getting a little overwhelmed, please step out of the courtroom, compose yourself, and then come back inside.
This was the case that just has followed me from that night.
It's still hard to believe two people did all those horrible things to him.
Gabriel Fernandez was, at the time of his death, 8 years old.
That was my friend, and it really caught me because it was his parent who took his life.
He was a very good kid, very playful, loving.
These two people murdered this child. How did this come to be?
How did a child who had so many signs of repeated and long-term abuse slip through the cracks?
It really wasn't until I got all of the evidence that I realized how egregious the case was.
This was a story that could not be ignored.
The question was, could we uncover what was really going on?
The Department of Children and Family Services has significant involvement in this case.
Board of Supervisors have now taken notice. There's something about this kid's death.
There was no medical follow-up, even to the injuries that were acknowledged by the department.
You're thinking about in your head, how could this be true?
As prosecutors, we need to up our game.
She didn't just prosecute the mother and her boyfriend. She also took the step of prosecuting the four social workers.
They had a job, and their job was to save the little boy.
The system is overtaxed. The most children I had was about 280. I did not commit a crime.
When the details came out of how this poor child was tortured and all of these people knew, I think it shook the county to the core.
Bureaucracies tend to function to preserve the institution at all costs.
The system has this enormous power.
There are those who think that by not talking, you can limit the bad publicity.
I believe the ultimate evil is seeing what's wrong and looking away when you have a power to make the difference. That is true evil.